Welcome back to the channel here. I'm Cliff and this is Red Rocket. Thanks so much for joining us in what is 2022. Yes, a brand new year for the channel. Sorry, we've been a little distance of late. What with Christmas, a bit of man flu and work getting in the way, we just haven't been able to bring you a video until now. But really excited to do so. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the Tesla Model 3, of course, and what I've thought about it 12 months in and 8,000 miles after driving. We'll cover some of the niggles and snags that I've had with the car since ownership and how Tesla have handled those. And actually, 8,000 miles in, do I still like the Tesla Model 3? Stick with the video to find out more. So a lot of you have been asking, what have I done with the Tesla since picking it up? Has it been ceramic coated? And indeed, did you PPF it? Well, yes, I did. I did both of those things. And we'll come to that in just a second, because many of you remember when I picked up this Tesla Shanghai built Tesla Model 3 from Birmingham Service Center, I went around it with a ruler, making sure there were no panel gaps. And we were really pleased that there weren't any panel gaps on the car. So it went straight down to Signature Group. I can't recommend them enough down here in Trentham. And they PPF'd and ceramic coated the car, and I was thrilled with it, absolutely pleased.
The guys at Signature Group completed a new car detail package for me. First off, they decontaminated the car and set to removing all those swirl marks. The Tesla preparation team had put on it for me. It had a full polish and then the PPF and ceramic coating could get added. The question I get asked the most in the comments is the price, just over £1,700.
Unfortunately though, when it came back, I realised that there was in fact a dent. Yes, a dent in the car, right here. Wasn't a dent from Signature Group, but it was actually on reviewing the footage that I'd taken on the day of collection, it was a dent that was there on collection, I'd just missed it. So I approached Tesla Service Center in Birmingham and they were really, really good about it. They agreed to take the car in and fix it up straight away for me. So when they did that though, unfortunately, unbeknown to me, they'd taken all the PPF off down the side of the car, which obviously caused a bit of a problem. And not only that, they'd also not properly sprayed the sill properly, so I got some white flecks in it. I was obviously very disappointed, but again, they agreed to have it back in and sort it out, as well as reimbursing me for the whole of the PPF that they'd removed from the car. So when I got the car back from the Signature Group, I did notice there was a blemish on the bonnet of the paint. I was convinced that this was an issue with the PPF, and I asked Signature Group to remove the PPF off the bonnet. Unfortunately, it wasn't the PPF at all. In fact, it was a blemish in the paintwork itself. You'll remember I did a video about concerns with my paintwork when I first picked up the car. You can check that video out here too. Tesla were really good about this when I raised it with them. They agreed to have the bonnet in and repaint it for me, which is exactly what they did. But unfortunately, when it came back, it had got what the industry call fish eyes. Lots of little craters all across the paint. It seemed that there'd been some kind of contamination of the paintwork when they'd been doing it. Not a problem, they had it straight back in. Of course, this does mean multiple trips to the service centre in Birmingham, about 30 to 40 miles away from me, round trip. Quite inconvenient, but still, Tesla were really good about it, and each time they gave me a courtesy car, or what many of you will know is as a loaner. So I got back to the Birmingham Service Center and they'd sorted out the bonnet. I was absolutely thrilled. I can't thank the guys at the Birmingham Service Center enough. My mechanic was brilliant. Constant updates via text, really convenient. If I was at work, I could just reply to him when I could. It was absolutely fantastic. And I think Tesla have really nailed their communication with their customers when their cars are in at the service center that way. Let me know your views though. You might have had different experience with Birmingham. Yeah, I was disappointed that I'd had to go to Birmingham a number of times for different parts of the paintwork on the car. But ultimately, the service and the people there were really good. In fact, when I got there, they opened the boot for me like this and show me the goodies that they've given me as a mark of apology for all the hassle that I've been to. I was really made up. I thought a really nice gesture from a company and people who didn't have to go to that much level for me. Ultimately, they've been fixing up my paintwork all on the warranty for no cost. and many manufacturers probably wouldn't have been so good about it. But I was really thrilled with these. We'll do another video opening and unboxing what we've had in the future. So stay tuned to the channel to see what the goodies are really like and what was the value of all the things that they gave me. I reckon there's a couple of £100 worth of stuff there. So stay tuned for more on that later on. So I got back home really thrilled with all the goodies, only to find a big dent right here. As you can see, they fixed the dent quite quickly for me. I drove it straight back to the service centre and they had it back in the next day. So I was pleased about that. Again, can't really fault the staff at Tesla at all. Really, really good customer service, and there was no argument that they caused it, as I'd spotted it just moments after I got back, having been thrilled with all the goodies that they'd given me. What do I think of a car after 8,000 miles of driving it nearly and 12 months on? Well, I have to say, you might say I'd say this, I'm still in love with the Tesla. Yeah, all those paint issues that I've had, but actually, anything mechanical? No. One of the great things, of course, with the Tesla that I really like about it is that Tesla are a software company. Yeah, they're making a car, but ultimately they're all about the software. And with Tesla, you get some really good updates over the air. Yeah, okay, other manufacturers are making small tweaks here and there to improve performance, but Tesla have given us a new user interface only at Christmas and some great little funky features such as the light show. You'll have seen my short video on that, which I think makes the Tesla that much more unique compared to other manufacturers who are bringing out some really good electric vehicles onto the market now, and there are some really good competitors, but Tesla have still got the edge, I think, with the user interface that they and the updates that they push out so frequently to their Tesla owners. Another great thing with the Tesla Model 3 in particular is the performance compared to its competitors on the market today. You can get other EVs yet, and there's some great ones coming on the market, but none with the performance versus the value and what you have to pay out for the car. So we get 0 to 60 in 4.2 seconds or thereabouts. We've done a speed test before. Check out the video and have a look at that one. But you know, we can also get the acceleration boost, and I'm really tempted into doing that. So maybe check back for a video shortly where we might just purchase the acceleration boost and see what we think of it. Of course, you do get 48 hours to get a refund on that, so maybe worth testing it if you're thinking, if you're umming and ahhing about it, but we'll do a video maybe on that. The other great thing about the Tesla, and specifically the Model 3, is the access to the Tesla Supercharger Network, a phenomenal service available in so many places and expanding every week throughout this year in the UK, meaning you've got access to super fast charging at your fingertips. So 8,000 miles in, 12 months of ownership. You've heard my story about my paintwork. Was I being a bit pernickety? Should I have just left the blemish and I wouldn't have had all the issues? Possibly so, but that's my personality. I wanted it just right, and probably rightly so. You're spending £50,000 on a car. You want it to be right. It's a phenomenal machine. It's an absolutely brilliant machine. This is a piece of tech you're buying into if you're buying a Tesla. Yeah, lots of other cars out there now, some fantastic EVs on the market that may suit your purpose better, but what you're buying into with a Tesla is technology. And for me, that's why this car is still the best on the market. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you're thinking of getting into a Tesla, I hope this video has been informative for you, maybe reassured you about some of the quality with the car, apart from the paintwork in parts. And as I say, possibly me being a bit pernickety, I've been absolutely thrilled with the way this car's been. No mechanical issues, nothing like that. So if you've been worried about battery, losing power, anything like that, put that out of your mindset and get yourselves down to Tesla. As you can see, I'm still a fan. Thanks so much for watching, and join us on the next one. Don't forget to hit the subscribe, the like, and follow the channel for future videos. Bye for now.